Hi everyone, so today on Celebsy Charcha, we have a highly versatile Bollywood singer and a sensational performer, Shweta Subram. Hi.
Hi Mayuri, thank you so much for having me and wonderful to be talking to you here.
Yes, same here. So Shweta, you have debuted, your debut in Bollywood was with Hawai Zada with Ayushman Khurana. You have performed in IFA, Carnegie Hall, along with Salim Suleiman, Sonu Nigam, and Shan. Wow, that's already a great body of work there. So,
thank you.
How did you get into singing, and when did it become your profession?
So, singing was always a hobby for me. I never thought of it as a profession, and never thought I'd make a career out of it. But after graduating from university, I actually won a few awards. I was actually in the singing competition, which was sort of a North American Indian Idol kind of concept. My friends pushed me into it and said, you know what, how does it hurt? Give it a shot, give it a try. So it was a 4-month long competition. I won that. And a bunch of other competitions took place, which I did very well in. And then pretty much that's where the turn, everything turned around. I basically decided to take the leap of faith and take singing professionally, not just as a hobby. So that all happened when I was about 22 years old. Yeah.
So tell me, which are your three most favorite Hindi cinema songs? And can you sing us some of them?
Sure. Yeah, that's a very difficult question for a singer.
Like three songs. Choosing three is a tough one. Yeah, I know that.
Yeah. So I will select three songs. One from Asha Ji, Aao Na Gale Lagaona. The other one I really like a lot is Sonu Nigam's Abhi Mujhme Kahi. And if I had to choose a third song, I would say Kehna Hi Kya from Bombay, Dhoomi Bombay. So great. Yeah, I really enjoy these songs. But again, like I said, it's a very tough pick. But I will sing a few lines. So I'll start with Asha Ji's Aao Na Gale Lagaona to begin with.
Aao na gale lagaona, lagi bujha do na, ho jaane ja. Tumne jo agar lagai hai, to chuke dekho na. कहाँ कहाँ अरे देखो सीने में कैसी हलचल मची है ओ साजना पर पप देखो सीने में कैसी हलचल मची है ओ साजना दूर 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 आऊ ना गले लगाओ ना लगे बुझा दो ना ओ जाने जा.
Yeah, it's fun.
Beautiful, beautiful. And are you going to sing, will you be singing the others also?
Okay, sure. I'll sing a few lines of that also. So second one I'm singing is Kehna Hi Kya.
Kehna Hi Kya ये नैनिक अनजान से जो मिली चलने लगे मोहब्बत के जैसे सिलसिले अरमान नहीं ऐसे दिल में खिले जिनको कभी मैं न जानूं वो हमसे हमसे कभी ना मिली कैसे मिले दिल न जानू अब क्या करी क्या नाम ली कैसे उन्हें मैं पुकारू कहना ही क्या ये नैनिक अनजान से जो मिली चलने लगे मोहब्बत के जैसे सिलसिले
ऐसे few lines.
Beautiful, beautiful, yeah. Beautiful there. Okay, now Tony, so who are you on the video? You're singing Asha Bhosle, and then you're doing this, you know, A.R. Rahman number, and this is sung by this A.R. Rahman. That's right. Oh my God, that's quite a range there, huh? I mean, Chitraji's voice is like totally different, and Asha Bhosle's style is totally different. So who is your inspiration? Who do you like look up to?
See, actually, as a singer, again, that's a very difficult question because you learn from so many different singers. You put it so rightly when you said that, you know, Asha ji is completely different, Chitra is completely different, and they both have different influences. But if I really have to pick one, interestingly enough, as a kid, I've been a huge fan of Sonu Nigam. And, you know, I always tried to follow his style of singing because he's such a versatile singer. Like, he can sing anything under the planet. And I really saw that when I had a chance of touring with him last year. I mean, despite how successful he is, it's just mind-blowing to see that he is so disciplined. You know, he does his riyas every single day. When I really think he doesn't need to do his riyas, okay? Like, he's so perfect. But he still does his riyas every single day. As a musician, he's fantastic. His sense of humor is amazing. And you learn so much from him. So he totally inspires me, and I've learned so much from him, and his dedication and his hard work is just unparalleled. So I think I would have to say Sonu Nigam is the person that inspires me every single day.
And how do you think, you know, when everything is happening, moving to digital platforms, you know, these days, everything is more and more digital. How do you think that is, you know, how is that taking the entertainment and the music industry, in which direction, and you know, how do you think it is it helping the entertainment world, the music world? What are your views on the digital platforms?
So ever since there's been like a paradigm shift, you know, from vinyl CDs, from physical CDs, to you know, embracing the internet and everything being online. Obviously, a lot of people didn't like it because they enjoy the good old days of, you know, saying that they own a record, right? But right now, we have to move with the times. That is the truth. That is the reality. And I feel that it's a natural evolution because technology has advanced. A lot of artists are actually getting to collaborate and share a lot because of digital platforms. Yeah. So we need to, you know, embrace this platform. And I really feel that it provides instant connectivity for artists around the world. Like, you know, take you and I, for example, you know, like, thanks to coronavirus lockdown, I'm sitting here in Dubai and you're sitting in India, right? Yeah. Today, we can still discuss a collaboration. We can still discuss ideas. We can even record from our homes. So I think we need to embrace technology, and everything that has happened, and all the digital platforms that are there. As an artist, I feel like tomorrow, if I want to release a single, like release an original, a song, all I have to do is just go on Spotify or go on Instagram and put out a message. And, you know, I think fans also enjoy that because they feel like a personal connection with the artist. Yeah. And they feel like the news is coming, you know, straight from the horse's mouth. So it's really, I think digital platform is honestly, is great. I'd like to see more of that. And I'm sure we're going to see more of that. It's a blessing. And despite where we are, well, we can remotely connect and collaborate. And it's wonderful. Let's be thankful for it. Yeah.
Such a treat to talk to you and listen to your beautiful voice. And
thank you so much.
India, we wish you all the luck in the world, and may you shine bright and brighter. And hope your shop setting in India happens soon.
I really hope so too. Fingers crossed.
Yes, and thank you so much once again, and let's stay connected.
Yeah, definitely we'll stay connected. And I'd like to thank the entire team for having me. It was really wonderful to hear from Monty and, you know, Dharmishtha and the entire team. And thank you for being so kind and graceful and for the beautiful interview. I really enjoyed every second of it. So thank you again. Hi, everyone. This is Shweta Subram, and you're watching me on Celebfee Media. Stay home, stay safe, and keep yourselves entertained by watching this space for more updates. Thank you again.
Thank you so much for your time.
Take care. Bye-bye.